Hi guys, what's up? This is Mac from Ekahau, and today I wanted to talk you through the importance of measuring walls attenuation. First of all, why is it important to measure walls attenuation? You want your predictive design to be absolutely spotless. But in order for that to happen, you need to go to the site and do something that we call a pre-design survey. As part of the survey, you capture information that you then feed into Ekahau, making sure that your predictive design is amazing. You want to understand the existing RF condition, DFS condition. You want to know where exactly you can or cannot place your APs and antennas. And most importantly, you want to know the attenuation of your walls, because it can be wildly different than your assumptions. Look at this design. We have assumed the attenuation of our walls to be around 1 to 3 dBs. Now, look at that design. We have measured this attenuation and it was between 12 and 16 dBs. We have predicted that we need just 3 APs based on assumed walls attenuation. In the real world, we need 7. And this might undermine your authority as a Wi-Fi engineer. It might cost your clients more and they might not want to speak to you again in the future. We understand why we need to measure walls attenuation. Now let's talk about how to do it. You do need to have Ekahau Sidekick connected to a survey device of your choice and a Wi-Fi radio, might it be AP on a stick, portable router, or your mobile hotspot. You need to position your Wi-Fi radio at least 5 meters away from the wall. Then you measure the RSSI on one side of the wall, and then you go to the other side of the wall and you also measure the RSSI. You take a look at the change of these two values and calculate attenuation of your wall. Please note that the Sidekick should be facing your Wi-Fi radio on both sides of the wall. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.